This is your KCTV 5 news update.
If you haven't gotten the shot yet, what would it take for you to do so? This afternoon, Missouri Governor Parson announced that the state is giving out big money to hundreds of people as an incentive to get a COVID vaccine. The prize is $10,000 with three drawings every 2 weeks. They'll be drawing in three categories to spread the reward money. One drawing is for adults who get vaccinated after today. Another is for adults who already got vaccinated. And the third drawing is for ages 12 to 17, where the prize is $10,000 in an education savings account. For the adults, the prize is $10,000 cash. Also during today's news conference, Governor Mike Parson introduced the state's new health director, Dr. Donald Koroff. Koroff will take over the agency September 1st, taking the place of Dr. Randall Williams, who announced a quick resignation and stepped down back in April. The Independence City Council has voted not to ban conversion therapy. That's the practice of trying to change a person's gender identity or sexual orientation. The Independence ban failed 4-3. Some members who voted against it say the ordinance was too broad. Still no decision from a city council committee on addressing the homeless issues across Kansas City. It's been getting a lot of attention since dozens of people living in tents near City Hall in Westport were moved to temporary shelter in hotels. But that temporary fix has expired and people are being removed from hotels, many ending up back in camps. Already this week, we've seen the return of what's called Camp 6 in Westport, but it was quickly moved to Penn Valley Park. Those testifying to the committee today say they're fed up.
There's no urgency. I invite the city council to go and become homeless. Live in your car until a decision is made, but don't live in your luxury ass house and make decisions for us when you can't feel us, you can't walk in our shoes.
And in that plan, there has to be permanency. There has to be housing. I'm not here to put down shelters, but shelters are shelters, they're not houses. We have to have a plan of action for our houseless community.
And don't expect resolution to any of these concerns anytime soon, because the committee doesn't meet again for 2 weeks. That's 4 days after an eviction moratorium is set to expire. Temperatures this evening will be slow to drop off, upper 70s by 11, but enjoy it because it is the mildest evening you get for at least the next week, down to about 70 in the morning on Thursday, upper 70s by 9, 88 degrees at lunchtime, 92 at 4 o'clock. That's about the same time the heat index works up to 98 degrees. Going to be a sizzler on Thursday, but still no excessive heat watch on Thursday. That doesn't start until Friday, when the real heat begins to work in. You can see it's only for the metro counties. The forecast track, it shows a slim chance for showers coming late Sunday, right there, and then Monday, right there. But both are very brief, only lasting for maybe an hour or two, and it doesn't amount to much rain, so you might want to think about watering the garden, giving it a little bit of tap water, because Mother Nature looks like it's going to be rationed out pretty well with less than a half inch of rain coming over the next week. Security Bank 7-day, 92 Thursday. It's all mid-90s after that through the weekend. 96 is both Saturday and Sunday, produce heat index values of 105. And that heat continues into the first half of next week. Stay cool and enjoy the next 7 days.
Turn to KCTV 5 News for the latest all day. This is your personalized update, because KCTV 5 News stands for you.